YouTubers, well, welcome to Millennium Falcon update, Diorama update number 16. Yes, and it's shut up. About 2:35 in the morning, so we've got to be very, very quiet. And my little friend R2 here has dropped by. In case you didn't know, this is the first prop I actually used in the very first film that I tried to be funny at, and of course I'm still trying. Oh my god, about 7 years ago, and he still works. He's a total idiot, and he's misbehaving too. Yeah, he keeps telling me something about the plants and his digital truck. You need to go to Betty Bye now. Where's your switch? What it is it's been freezing the last couple nights here in Florida. I don't know about freezing tonight, but my wife, and that's because I'm having a bad hair night, because whenever it gets this humid, my hair goes. So I'm not sharing that with you. And my wife has piled up plants in a corner of the studio here, and you can see a shot of that. They do seem to be sort of advancing, don't they? Yeah. Anyways, we'll get back to that. And so R2 freaks out at that. Anyway, so yeah, like 7-8 years ago, he was the first prop I used showing, when I first got the Enterprise E kit, which I didn't get around to building for years and years afterwards. I was still like tied up with like lots and lots of projects. And so I brought him out of the closet and I cleaned him up, but sure enough, he still works. It's wonderful. Let's see. Yes, it's freezing outside. I fell asleep around 6 p.m. I had one of those crash things. I don't sleep like normal people. I just go. I wake up hours later, and then I don't sleep for 2-3 days. It's, I don't know. Bowie died, but the one thing I shared with him is I wasn't from this planet. It was this funny thing. It was, what was it? The two guys from Men in Black, Tommy Lee Jones, and the other fellow, Will, I can't remember, but I know it's Will something. Anyways, they're at a bar or something, or at an eatery, or a Greasy Spoon, and Will looks at him and he says, did you hear Bowie died? And Tommy Lee Jones looks at him and says, no, he just went home. And I love Tommy Lee Jones. God, what a great actor. Everything he's in, I absolutely adore. Anyways, what else? So it's really late at night. Obviously, I'm not in my right mind. I've got some really, really big results to show you. The wife went to bed early. I went to bed earlier. So I got like 4 or 5 hours sleep, which means like a full night. So I woke up and said, well, nothing to do. It was freezing outside. The cat ran out and, you know, froze instantly. And he'll thaw in the morning. So I got to work on the diorama. I had all the portions pre-built, all the sections were ready to go. So it was just a question of glue, solidifying, structurals, and blah, blah, blah. And amazingly, it went quite quickly. As a child, I played with Legos, and it's so very helpful. Buy Legos for your child. Ka-ching. Yes, endorsement. No, man. I wish, though, because I did love Legos, and I bought my grandson's, like, $500 worth of Lego, and every time they come over, it's like, and it just lately got to learning him how to, or teaching him, correct grammar, how to pick him up and put him away before he leaves. Anyways, so I'm going to show you the structure completely assembled. Now, without the details inside the hangar bays, which I found these really great, like, cargo areas and crates and all kinds of good stuff that I saw in there. The three landing lights that I saw on the landing pad, I've got figured out how to construct from scratch, build parts and some electronics. There, I don't know if it was actually in the film, but in my diorama, There will be some lighting coming, sort of like casting a little bit of light on some of the doors that are closed in the dioramas. Interest points. It's actually, I can still smell the primer. I only got it done a few hours ago. But I got done to a point where I can't texture paint yet, not until tomorrow. So I said, well, I'm still good for a few more hours before I go crash for another few hours. Yeah, it's like that. It's like my days involve like five shifts, you know. Two sleeping ones and three working ones. Yeah, you're like 9-to-5 life. I have no idea what that's meant. Sorry. It's not the way it works here. Again, we are not from your planet in this film. Also, let's see. I just started a website on Facebook called Paranormal Tech. Now, the main website is called ParanormalTech.net, which is hosted by GoDaddy, which I started maybe 2-3 months ago. Which is, of course, you guys know, if you know anything about me, is I do the modeling and all that, but my passion is the occult and doing ghost investigations or paranormal investigations. And I posted everything that I had actually posted 3 months ago on Google Plus. Now, Google, and you know, started Google Plus as some sort of, matched content to Facebook. They were competing with Facebook, and they thought, you know, eventually we'll take over Facebook. Guess what? I got like maybe a few hundred views on Google Plus. I had 4 followers. Well, with a call to action on Facebook and with the 495 friends I had on Facebook, in one day I had more action going on in the, you know, equivalent version of Paranormal Tech on Facebook that I had on Google Plus in 3 months. So honestly, Google Plus, yeah, I don't think you're gonna give, you know, Facebook a run for their money anytime soon. As a matter of fact, I think you should really put out the pasture on Google. I think you're wasting your time. Google Plus is pretty much a useless little program that isn't going anywhere. Sorry. Facebook, not that I like everything about Facebook, is 1,000 times better. And the one thing that they that Google Plus had was those ability to have meetings or have, you know, like live broadcasts and all that. Well, of course, Facebook caught on to that. And just lately, I've been doing a few live broadcasts. As silly as they are, not going to be quite as silly as this video is going to end up being, I'm sure. But, you know, Facebook's caught on to the few things that people went to Google Plus or gravitated to Google Plus. And Google Plus. And Google Plus, you're nowhere, man. I'm sorry. You need to, if you want to compete at all, you're going to have to offer some really cool sort of offbeat things that Facebook never thought of before, because you're nowhere. I'll show you a little bit of what the Facebook Paranormal Tech page looks like. Got some great stuff on that. We've actually, being new at it at the beginning, got some extremely wild stuff at the St. Augustine Lighthouse, which we did not expect, which kind of gave us like a very quick, solid training as to the fact of what to expect. And dude, you know, be really ready for things to open up real fast. And if it's going to scare you right off the bat, then walk away. But we didn't. And we were really surprised. I think people can wait years to have the results we got the very first few times we went out there. But like I've said, I seem to be a magnet for weirdness, so maybe in a way I wasn't surprised. As far as the one video that's posted up there where we said in the location we could mention, you guys know what it is. I mentioned it in several videos because I didn't mention it at the time and all that. It is mentioned in my Facebook page. I refrain from mentioning it here, although legally speaking, I probably could mention it. It's in Daytona Beach. It's where the author Stephen Crane wrote partially the very famous classic, The Red Badge of Courage, after he had a shipwreck here and had to stay at this particular place. It's within a few miles of where I live. We paid to film and do a ghost hunt there. The owner had agreed, if she had no major objections to the quality of the film, she was going to allow us to mention the place. But then when we showed her what was in her basement, which was, my God, if it wasn't a demon, or it was what I call an elemental, something, and guys, look it up. I'm tired of mentioning it. It's something that's part of the earth. And they're all over the earth, and they've never been human or walked under the sun in a body or physical form. Elementals are just something that's part of the earth, because the earth is a living organism. Look that up. There's many versions of it. My version of it is what shamans and older tribes regarded as their spirit, their Manitou, what they appeal to when somebody was sick or dying or whatever, had a lot of power. Elementals have personalities. They can be mean, friendly, funny. If they like you, pretty much leave you alone or even help you. If they don't like you, you can have a very bad day. Or it could be like your last day. I don't know. Rambling Simon. Get to the model. I know. I hear you, man. I hear you. You know, the vibe sensors are on. Anyways, let's see. What else? So then we'll take a look at the actual base where it's at, which, believe me, after just about a half a day construction, since I had all the parts ready, was really more of a question of making solid. So let's see. I rambled on for how long now? Oh, my God. Okay. Wait a minute. That's what R2 was talking about. Look, I got to tell you, these plants here that I brought in for my wife at my wife's, she doesn't know that the backyard... Okay, that thing's definitely moving. The backyard, as you guys have known from prior, where is it? From prior videos, isn't a normal backyard. Well, you guys know. Now, it's sort of a vortex kind of backyard. And weird things happen back there. And she's going to... Which I've asked her not to do. I've asked her not to do, but she doesn't understand. You guys know, though. Yeah, you know. Okay. That thing's getting really close. Hey, get off my desk, man! I told you! Sorry, you know. I'll be right back. You guys need to calm down. I'll get you back out in the sun tomorrow. Tonight you're in here, but that's it. That's it. Yeah, I know. It's okay. Don't get me mad. Don't get me upset. We're gonna calm down now. Okay. So these plants are like a little different. So, let's move on with the film, and we'll let Botanical Smurf deal with some of the more hurt plants. All right, so a quick look at the Paranormal Tech page on Facebook. I just wanted to share this with you. I did close the one on Google Plus because it had 4 followers. Yeah, Google Plus is going to compete with Facebook, right? Good luck with that. So, basically, structured the same, except with the Facebook interface. Thank you all for the 116 people that answered my call. Really appreciate that. Of course, the usual posting, very cute. Where is it? a guy I ran into, I believe, at MegaCon, who heavily into the Ghostbusters thing, sent a little picture of his little fellow with a Ghostbusters uniform, and he said, I love the fact that this even exists. You have a budding recruit should you need one, and I answered, he's hired. Very cute. So, of course, all the postings, every film that we ever did, all the films, in case you've never ever seen one of our films, the one, of course, where the entity is, the ones where we went to St. Augustine Lighthouse, which are very, very interesting. And a set of pictures from those events. Now, what I'd like to share with you, let's see. Let's see if we can actually go to one that's better positioned for you. Some great pictures on this thing, there really is. Let's see. Where are they? Well, I suppose we're going to have to do that. I may have to cut here, or just simply lower the camera. Let me see if I can do this. So you guys can see this. This was pretty wild. This is when we went to that site. And if you go to my Facebook page, you can actually find out where it is. I don't publicly want to reveal it because if I do, one of the little old ghastly ladies or one of their board members might cause me some grief. So we were at this place, this historical, federally funded or backed or whatever, historical place where Stephen Crane stayed and wrote the Red Badge of Courage after, or partially wrote it, after a shipwreck here off Daytona Beach. It is history, it is facts. And Steve went downstairs to the basement where he wanted to start, and his phone turned on for no reason, and it was turned completely off. So we knew it was gonna be interesting. And right upstairs in what's called the toy room or the children's room, the recording device, right away the batteries were sucked dry. And this was happening all night. Units, and here's a little bit of a, started to see that entity when we were down in the basement. This was later. And that thing scared the bejesus out of Steve. You can see it right there. Steve was so scared, he wasn't holding the camera up to this thing because while you're looking at it, it's live motion, but you can only snap pictures of it. I'm going to get a more sophisticated flare, but these things run up to the tens of thousands of dollars. They're very sophisticated ones. That's a lower-end model that I actually could afford. Interesting, when we actually got the heck out of there, we got a little parting message on the Avilus 4. And it was like, disregard, like, don't bother telling anyone. Later, and it's signed Beast. Here's some of the interesting little pictures. Again, note the horn projections, the claws coming down. And later on, when we looked at it, and other people looked at it, they said, notice that he has little buddies popping up in the back. We thought it was just him. And people were like, well, that's just, you know, the temperature and all that. No, actually, it was a warm February day. It got cold that night. But notice how even the temperature is, except for these thingies. But there was no AC running. There was no heat running. It was absolutely, you know, stable temperatures. And this is what we were looking at. And this thing here is a storage bin where he was kind of hanging around, and he was coming up around here somewhere. Well, we couldn't see it on the night vision. We could not see it in his full spectrum camera. We couldn't see him anywhere else but on the flare. And here we outlined him. And yeah. And again, he was moving. This is why the shapes are changing. And again, these, look here, man, like almost a perfect alien face. Where did that come from? And it's almost like it wasn't the depth of the room that was defining where they were coming from. You remember, these are dimensional or spiritual beings. They were going beyond the limit of the room because this is in the basement. So they were coming out of the earth, which makes me think this thing was maybe what the Indians were, you know, using as the shamans were appealing. I mean, look at this, a perfect profile. And if you go to the website, you'll see what I mean. There's two perfectly distributed eyes, darker shapes, on the side of its face. And the other thing here has eyes. And it almost like a dog shape here starting to emerge. That was a busy basement. And here, wow, again, the two eyes, very well-defined horns, and what appears to be a wing unfurling. I mean, that's got to be the scare. Oh, and that one really freaks me out. I mean, it's only later did we realize just how freaky it was. Now, upstairs before we went downstairs, Uvalis 4 was giving us some interesting stuff. What's really weird is murder came up 3 times. Now, we asked the owner about it. She says, oh, no, we've never had any events here. Of course, I don't believe a darn thing she says. And, I've never seen the Ovalis. I didn't even know that word was on this thing. Murder coming up 3 times. And it was rather odd what was coming up. It said England in 30. Well, his paramour, or his lady friend, was from England. And from what we've been able to dig up from some of the books about him, he died at the age of 30. Go figure. A lot of the house, not much happened. There's Steve getting kind of freaked out in the toy room. We didn't catch a lot, but again, the equipment failure. Now, the was drained of power. Now, I did pick up some strange little squeals and laughs and stuff, but because it was polluted, as in, this is right next to a busy street. That's Silver Beach Bridge. Lots of traffic and all that. Although I did pick up some things on the audio, I cannot use it because it was polluted by outside noises. This is Papa slowly going down the stairs. Wish I could come up as quickly as Steve did, but was not to be. And while we were going around in the basement, I thought I saw a shadow before we caught the entity. And sure enough, I wish I could show you. There's a picture that a friend of ours, a friend of the site, sent to us, and it's in the beginning of one of my other videos, that he actually caught the entity sitting still in the air, a dark shape. And at the beginning of when we get down in the basement, I mentioned, what was that? And there you go. So a very interesting and fun place. I got to display the pictures a little bit better than I liked on the Google Plus. There's some films. The Paranormal Safari is where you can hire us, bring a date, whatever. And we'll either take you to St. Augustine Lighthouse, which is a place where something always happens, or if you have like legal ability to go onto a property that you've always wanted to check out, that you've heard is interesting, we can go there. It's not super cheap. I mean, you know, you got to figure, we got to get to you. We got to bring our equipment. There's gas involved. You're hiring both of us. I'm not saying it's thousands here, but it is, you know, a specialty kind of thing. So if you're into something different and you're not struggling to pay the rent, give us a call over there. Ghostbuster, give us a call, you know. But seriously, something very interesting to do. I guarantee you it's an experience I've never forgotten of any of the hunts we've done. If you want to do something real interesting and join the team for one night, check it out. Anyways, that's a look at paranormal tech, and let's move on. Okay, so here on the table, you can see the now fully assembled basic structure. I mean, the overall structure, none of the little details yet, like the little pipes or any of the cargo inside the tunnels, or I should say the little garages or whatever, storage docks. And you can see how big it is. It's a good size. It literally fills from edge to edge the entire glass case. And, yes, Millennium safe. And I let this thing drive for several hours. This film took a few hours to film. And you see the top cap here, which helps make the wall actually a whole lot stronger. And, you know, I'm not using the very good tripod tonight. It's very heavy, and it's stored way back down here, deep in this bag, and I'm not going there. So we're just going to have to take this. So the paint I'm using to start working, the basic base paint, which will give me that rock finish, is by Krylon, and it's called Coarse Texture Travertine Tan. And if you look at the cap, that's exactly what I want. I don't want a nice flat texture. I want Tatooine desert-like features. And if you take a look at this still, notice the nice Mojave colors, which is why when I went to Arizona to deliver the Boers, I was really paying attention to those. So that's going to be the overall color, except on the doors, I believe. I'm not going to put it. But everywhere else, pretty much, it's going to be like that. Now, let me turn this puppy around and give you an idea of what I'm talking about as far as finishing it, since it will be viewable from all sides, although I imagine the client will put it up against the wall and let the pretty side show. Well, it doesn't make a whole lot of sense to me otherwise. Moving on. Now here's a rear look at it. Now this, of course, will be the back end of the glass case. Now what we're going to have to do here is, even though it's finished nicely in the front, it's still got to be finished in the back, because, you know, if he puts it in the central viewing area where people can access the back of it, 90% of the time it won't be that way. I still have to compensate for that. Plus, overall, the structural has to be stronger this way. This is how it will be done. For instance, in the back, I've given room. Oh boy. I use this for crazy this one night. Anyways, a panel will cover this up all the way down to the bottom. There will be probably a split angled panel, one this way, one that way, with a triangular one sealing the top, and so on and so forth. So this whole back end will also be finished. I figure in the back here, probably a sort of a Mojave look to it. So overall, the whole thing will be very pretty. There's also in some of these doors that are shut, I have purposefully left three or two open slots that will have some lighting in there. So there's a bit of a splash down the doors. So even if the ship is off, if he wants to have the option, this will be a separate button, a third circuit apart from the ship, just to make the ship sort of highlighted with the diorama itself, just giving a little effect lighting. It will be there. So very, very cool display. Will offer a whole lot of fun stuff. What still remains also here, like for instance, where, trying to get that lighting in there. Over here, let's close in on that a little bit. Right now, I'm just on the fly, kids. Woo! Cut here. Cut here. On this particular one here, the door, this is one of the few sections that was a little different. It's sort of a mutant. Actually, there were these little square sections that were actually part of the columns. I kind of did one a little different, incorporating those details just to make it a little different. There'll actually be three pipes going in here and three pipes coming out. It's just sort of make it a little interesting, a little different. Because overall, it wasn't super interesting. It was the ship that was interesting. I believe our diorama will be wrapped up. There are, if you recall, on the floor, there are three lighted deck lights, a couple of machines in there. And, of course, in here, I've got some great, great stuff. Matter of fact, I'll give you just a look at some of these crate part things I have. But I've gotten these from various kits. Great stuff. My God, I've got primer all over my hands, so forgive it. I'm not dirty, I'm just an artist. And just to give you an idea, look at this stuff. This is off a Moonbus kit. If you cut it all over the place here and all that, you'd have just a plethora of fun stuff that's going to be in there. Looking like it's ready to be loaded or been waiting for shipment or whatever. So there you go. And even those little, and if I can close in on that. And remember now, this is before that texturing paint has been loaded up there. And even those grills that are going to have all that nice weathering spill going down all around those columns. I'm not terribly unhappy with that. And of course, in between each of these columns, between the doorways, the fireworks go final. If we take a look here, let me get it in focus. You'll notice this is an illustration, but in the actual film, all the doors were closed, but I wanted to give a little variety. Under each of these doors, there's a detail that shows sort of, I guess, the interlock between the door and the floor indent. And I'm going to have to add this pattern on and make it look real. There's those lights I was talking about. This is actually just my diorama would actually end about here, so you won't see that, but you will see these. And, of course, there's all those crates. I'm actually putting more crates. And we will have crazy little stormtroopers not shooting at the ship, actually just sort of standing around going, well, it's a boring evening. And the piping, of course, details will be in there. There she is. That's actually a great illustration. I got that off Google Images, and you can, too. Just type in the right words and get all kinds of magical stuff. So I guess that about does it. So we've had a good look at the new Paranormal Tech dot site, and our Paranormal Tech at Facebook, and of course Paranormal Tech dot net, hosted by Google Plus, and we've taken a look at this lovely piece of work, which this week will be textured painted, and I'm almost sure it'll be all done by the end of the week, if not very early next week, and then a fantastic film by Richard Cave. From Rockhopper VFX. And then we'll be moving on, I believe, to an Excelsior Star Trek starship with some fun stuff and remote control lighting. Something we haven't shown you guys before, which is available now. And has been available. It's not rocket science, but it once was. Now I guess we'll move on to the video. The video is strange. I haven't seen it, but Editor Smurf says it's made up of a lot of security cameras out there. And boy, the professor we all thought was such a great guy. He must help. He left the perimeter defense system he developed, which is quite deadly, activated. And poor old Sarge boy, he almost got himself, well, I don't know if he did or not. Actually, I haven't watched it. So check it out. So this is Papa Smurf. Have a great week. And we'll see you next time for update number 17, I believe. You all have a great week and take care. You know, boys and girls, somehow Papa's yard, it's light and dark, I can't see the sun, and just before I went through this cluster of empty buildings, which is all you find sometimes when you go through these doorway thingies that he talks about, it was a bright afternoon. I don't get it. And somehow I feel like I'm being watched. What the hell is that? Holy Toledo. Something's targeting me. I can feel it. Smurf, I don't know what's up, man, but that backyard of yours is cursed or something. I don't know what's going on. I mean, there was people shooting at me back there, and then you go through these little weird things, and there's this glow.
Well, Sarge, that? I did tell you about those sort of weird dimensional gateways. Yeah, I know. Not much I can do about it.
Backyard, man, there's things shooting at me. Was this Russia?
Well, I think the professor was testing out that perimeter defense system.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. You were back there?
Perimeter defense system. The German guy. Uh-huh. Okay. Well, thanks, Papa.
Yeah, well, I'm going to go to my barrack now. I just got to do one thing first. All right, thank you.
Yeah, see you later, Sarge. Right out. Oh, boy.
Okay. Uh-huh. Yeah. Yes. Well, yet another defense test of the perimeter defense system designed by Manfred von Zippenstein. Stop it. Of gigantic proportions. I've got little rocket launchers, tiny machine guns. After all, this is a modeling channel. Things are scaled up. Yes, and worked very, very well. How about? Seems to indicate something alive walked through. I don't know what it was. Big, bulky, could have been a bear. Not sure. Yeah. I've got this odd feeling I'm being watched, or something's. I don't know, it's a cold feeling. Anyways, I hope you have a lovely day, and, what's that noise?